Hi again, my dear students. Welcome to our next lesson for today, and we are going to talk about the classification of musical instruments, the sac or bostel system. You have to learn about these classifications because you need this in order for you to classify your instruments in your instrumental music topics. Okay, let's start. So we have four classifications. So first, as you can see, we have idiophones. Next, we have membranophones and chordophones and also aerophones. Let's explain this one by one. First is idiophones. Idiophones are musical instruments in which a vibrating solid material is used to produce a sound. And examples of solid materials are like stones, wood, and metal. Idiophones are differentiated according to the method used to make it vibrate. Always take note of the words that are underlined in this presentation. For example, in idiophones, you need to take note that these instruments are vibrating solid materials in order for them to produce a sound. In playing these instruments, you need to take note of the following, like concussion, the friction, percussion, scraped or they are shaken, or being stamped or stamping. So what is a concussion? So this concussion way of playing is when a pair of similar instruments are struck together, okay? Or they are struck against each other. So when that instrument is being played by striking each other, so that's a hint that that's an idiophone instrument. Okay, what about the friction? So this way of playing is when you're producing sound when you are rubbing, okay? Rubbing the instrument to produce a sound. When we say percussion, this is idiophone instruments that produce sound by striking or using some striker in order to produce a sound like xylophones, triangles, and so on. And the other way of playing it is self-explanatory, okay? Like when the instrument is being shaken, scraped, or stamped. And here are the example instruments for idiophone instruments like triangle, woodblock, maracas, bell, and gong. Okay, let's proceed to the next classification, and that is a membranophone. This one is a musical instrument that is a vibrating stretch membranes or skin to produce a sound. And membranophones are classified according to the shape of the instrument. Again, remember, membranophones, there is a presence of a stretch membrane or a skin. So it means there is something being stretched at the top of it in order for you to play or in order for it to hit to produce a sound. Of course, an example instrument for membranophones are your drums. Let's proceed to the next classification, and this is chordophones from the word itself, okay? Take note. Chordophones produce sound by means of a stretched vibrating string. So when the string vibrates, the resonator picks up that vibration and amplifies it, giving it more appealing sound. Okay, so take note, chordophones, that's a presence of a string. Okay, chords, string. Here are examples of instruments for chordophones. We have bajo, guitar, harp, mandolin, and ukulele. And now let's have our last classification, that is an aerophone. Okay, what is an aerophone? This classification of instruments are producing sounds by vibrating a column of air. Okay, they're commonly known as wind instruments. And take note again that aerophones need air in order to play. So aerophones, wind instruments. And this instrument has four basic types, and let's have the first one, that is a brass wind, and these are made of metal, particularly brass. These instruments create sound through the vibration of a player's lip on the mouthpiece. Next one, we have woodwinds. Of course, woodwinds, the instruments were originally made of wood, but now other materials are used. Next, we have free reed, and this refers to wind instruments that have a freely vibrating reed, and the pitch depends on the size of the reed. Free aerophones are those in which the sound is produced by a column of air outside of the instrument itself, such as the bull roarer or a whip where it's cracked. Okay, here are the example instruments for aerophones classification: trumpets, clarinet, piccolo, flute, saxophone, accordion, tuba, harmonica, and horn. And again, those are the four classifications of musical instruments by Zach Hornbostel. Just always remember all the keywords, and these classifications are always there, okay, in your activities, in every music classes you have. So you need to master this, and you need to really study about these classifications. So God bless you and enjoy your music classes. Thank you for your time, and see you again in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe.